Hi there, welcome to my channel. So if you've been following my Hackerrank playlist, you might find out that what I'm doing is one, solve Hackerrank challenges, which is going to help you in your code interviews for different companies. But also I'm teaching little bits and pieces in Python that will help solve that problem. That's why I have this Jupyter notebook on the right, just helping me to show you how things work in Python. So far we've solved a couple of different number of Hackerrank problems, but for today, we're gonna write a function, and that's a bit of a difficult one compared to what we have done before, but trust me, it's very easy. Let's go ahead, let's solve this challenge. So this is my stdin or stdin where we write the code, and at the bottom we will have the stdout once we run the code. Like always, please read the task really, really carefully because that really matters. That really allows you to submit your code without any really resubmissions. Before that, before I read the task, let me just run you through what's happening in the white area. So you will write a function that will decide if a year is a leap year or not. And I will get back to that. And then you have the execution part. That's essentially when we use this function to say, is this a leap year or not? As long as you don't run this second part, the first part will be just lines of letters and that's it. It's not gonna be able to do anything. It's like you buy a hammer for your warehouse, but as long as you don't use it, it's just sitting there. It's essentially taking the hammer and putting the nail into the wall that does the job. So this is your hammer, and this is the action of taking that hammer and using it. That's the analogy that I would like to give you. And also about this function, let me run you through the fact that we assume that the year the person gives us is not a leap year. This is for that. We say leap, false. I am assuming any year that we are in is not a leap year unless you tell me the conditions on what is a leap year and then give it back to the user. Say, is it false, it's not a leap year, or is it true, it is a leap year? So let's see what the actual task is here. An extra day is added to the calendar almost every 4 years as February 29. Yes, because we know February is normally 28 days. And the day is called a leap day. It corrects the calendar for the fact that our planet takes approximately 365.25 days to orbit the sun. Oh, that's interesting. A leap year contains a leap day. Cool. In the Gregorian calendar, three conditions are used to identify leap years. Beautiful. This is where I can start typing my code here. The year can be evenly divided by four is a leap year. How can I find out if a year, for example, year 1993, how can I find out if it is evenly dividable by four? Very easily. Just use the modulo. This is called the modulo of that number by four. So I can see that the modulo of 1993 by four is one. What does that mean? Well, let me show you. Four modulo four, let's run that, is zero. Because if you divide four by four, you don't have anything remaining without anything to do. Like there is one times four inside four. How about five? Five modulo four means that, well, you can take one four out and then you are left with number one. So that's the meaning of modulo. If you haven't seen the video on that one, the link is up the top right. Condition number one, the year can be evenly divided by four. Okay, let's start writing. If year modulo four equals zero, means that if you divide that year by four, you will not have anything left. Everything can be easily evenly divided by four. That's condition number one. So it is, the year can be evenly divided by four is a leap year unless the year can be evenly divided by 100. So this is condition number two. If year modulo 100 equals zero is not a leap year unless the year is also evenly divisible by 400. Okay, if year modulo 400 equals zero as well, then you will say leap equals true. So it has to be divisible by four, divisible by 100 and 400. then it is a leap year. I am missing one little bit. So it says if it is divisible by 4 and it is divisible by 100, it has to be divisible by 400 to be a leap year. Otherwise, if it is divisible by 4 and it is not divisible, sorry, go back once, and it is not divisible by 100, it is still a leap year. Let me run you through. The wording says the year can be evenly divided by 4 is a leap year. If it is divisible by 4, it is a leap year. Unless the year can be evenly divided by 100. So if it is divisible by 4, and if it is not divisible by 100, then you're fine. It's a leap year. But if it is divisible by 4 and it is divisible by 100, the only way it is a leap year is that it is divisible by 400. So we need three conditions to meet here, and we only have one condition down here to meet. So let's run that. Congratulations, it worked, but this is only one test. Let's submit the rest of the test. We will have, wow, that's great, it worked. I hope you really enjoyed it. If you did, hit the like button, subscribe to my channel because I'm going to go through every HackerRank plot problem and solve it for you. Thank you.